worship, that I'm going to lift him up, that I'm going to live a holy and a righteous lifestyle before him.
You better preach.
It's all in your mindset, the turn away of your mindset. You can activate the things of God and move into the things of God because you've changed your mind. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty and the majesty of his holiness as the creator and the source of holiness. People of God, it's crucial that we get to this place of truly worshiping and seeking God. And being able to push past our own issues. There should be no reason why you came to this event and you feel like you didn't get anything. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yes.
There should never be a time period where you come into the fellowship of believers and you feel like that you didn't get anything. There's something wrong. Does that make sense? Like, do you really get that?
Yes.
Like, does that, let that register in your mind. Like, you waste, but sometimes we'll be in church for hours. You didn't jump around, you didn't sweat it out, you didn't lay down on the floor, you didn't went prostrate, and all of it was for nothing because your heart wasn't in it, your mind wasn't in it, you were no. You might as well have stayed home for all of that.
That's right. That's right.
So I encourage you, and I lift you up, and I love you, and I hope that you get to this place where it's just like you go home and you be like, God, help me how to worship you. One more thing. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. It was about the Samaritan woman. And the Holy Spirit shared this with me this morning. It was God, the scripture where it says that God is a spirit. And those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. And what I realized is that it says in spirit and in truth, not in the soulless realm. So nothing ever based off your emotions. So when we worship God, it should never be because of how I'm feeling. But because of the strictly fact of the truth of who he is.
Yeah.
If God is who he says that he is, if he's the creator, if he's holy, if he's righteous, if he'll never leave you, if he'll never forsake you, if he'll never leave you, and he says he has all these promises, then we should worship him simply based off the facts.
Right.
Based off the truth, and that's who he is. And sometimes we pray, we worship God in the soulless realm and in the perception of our minds. So when we get our money in the mail, or we get that A, or we get that A in that class, and we get that whatever it is that we wanted, it's always easy to worship God and praise God. But when all hell is breaking loose in our life, it's just like, God, you ain't doing enough. And it just, I encourage you to just really just take that time and really just seek God in your relationship.
That's right.
Really get to that place of truly being able to worship. Coming into the house of God and coming together and recognizing that it's more than a fashion show. It's more than to look cute. It's more than a dance competition. It's more than whoever's looking the best. But it's about the inside of your heart, because that's what God's looking at. We see the cuteness of how you look on the outside and all y'all do look fly. But it's like God is looking at your heart. Does your heart look as fly as your outfit does on the outside?
Wow.
But my time is up. I thank you, and God bless you, and just continue to be that area of worship. It's not, the area of worship wasn't here. You should have brought the area of worship when you came.
Yeah.
If you came here expecting an area of worship, you already late.
Thank you.